Good morning. Day 10 of the breeding challenge. I'm just going to blether away here until we get some people in to join us. It's been a really great fun challenge, I have to say, because so many people have got involved and so many people are feeling the benefits already just in 10 days. I mean, it's just incredible. And also I think just doing it together, it's just so powerful and it's fun. And you know, what can happen is as you get older and more bombarded with information is that you kind of lose. Morning, Sean. Hi, darling. Morning, Clementine. So we can really lose our sense of humour. Morning, Patricia. And forget, you know, that we can still have fun and we can still look on the light-hearted side of life. And certainly, you know, as we get older, it becomes, you know, Victor Meldrew is a very stereotypical character of somebody. Morning, Janice. Victor Meldrew is a very stereotypical happens. Morning, Pat. Is as you get older, you lose your sense of humour, you become more crabbit, you become more cynical, you become more tired. Morning, Janice. So we need to make sure that no matter what is happening out there, and just before I was coming on live, morning, Caroline, I watched a couple of news items and you're just like, I mean, it's insanity what's going on right now. So it's really a good idea. You want to keep informed. We need to be informed. Morning, Karen. But also, you also need to be aware. I hope things are better by May. It's your 40th in May, Sean. I absolutely hope so too. Yes, for sure. Because I missed my 60th birthday party. So hopefully we'll be able to have one this year. Because you and me together, that's 100. So, yeah, so really, again, being aware of what's going on is critically important because, you know, that's one of the things that being in a democracy can breed is that we just become, we think, oh, somebody else will fix it. And we take our eye off the ball as to what them in power are doing. So we need to really be aware and we need to be participating in our own communities. But we also need to stay sane, which is like more and more challenging as the weeks go on and the madness seems to mount. So breathing. So again, I just want to thank you all for joining in. It's just been, I've really, really been enjoying it. And I think if you're up for it, we'll carry on doing something every week so that we can really stay on top of the stress levels and our goals and our dreams and our visions for the new earth and a planet that serves all of us and not just a select few. Hi, Emma. Yes, sanity rules. And so does insanity by the looks of things. So the simple act of breathing differently, and as I've said to you all before, researching for this book to bring you Scotland's wild medicine. It's wild because a lot of the medicine grows around, literally round about your garden, by the rivers. You know, even if you're in a city, you can go to a park and you'll be able to find the medicine that Claire is collected, where it's like the really simple, easy to recognise medicines. And then what I'm doing is I'm talking about the wild medicine that we never knew about. For example, getting into the cold water, being in the trees. Now, a lot of people do know this, I understand, but I think even for me, who's been a big nature and been outdoor lover for a long time, I didn't truly understand all the reasons why being in natural light, why the wind, why radiant, a natural open fire, why the medicine that just grows literally in season for you right there. You know, I'm just seeing this whole conscious, intelligent planet in a completely new way. And, you know, it makes you wonder how we ever went down that rabbit hole of the big pharma and the big corporations, the greed, taking what's out there and selling it back to us. you know, and also and very often in an altered form that's not quite as intelligent as it is in the way Mother Nature gives us it. So my faith and my trust goes out into nature, and this body and your bodies, they all are intelligent. We all started as one single cell. Think of this. And it just divided and divided and divided until it got you and me. I mean, is that, if that's not intelligence, I don't know what is. How did they know what to do? And Bruce Lipton's incredible work shows that you change the environment and the cells behave differently. So the cells, we are not a victim of our genes. We are the master manipulator of our genes, and we can manipulate genetic expression. Now, for a long, long time, I focused on food. And I still think, you know, I love healthy food anyway, so it's not really a drama for me. But when you're living in a small village in Scotland, sometimes you don't have access to a great range of fresh food. So, but now the breath, and I remember an ex-priest in Malta telling me, he said, we're going to wake up to the power that we can change our chemistry no matter what we eat. Now, would that not be pretty incredible? Because see, trying to get people to change their diet, that's why I loved being a nutritionist, but there's no point in me telling people what to eat and then them not eating it and not getting the result and then lying to me about what they ate. Morning, Mark. Good to have you here. So they're trying to change people's dietary habits in Scotland, particularly, where we have one of the poorest health records on the Western world. And that is something that we can change, and we are changing simply by doing this. We are elevating our status. So if we just forget about food for now, and then start to think about changing the chemistry with the breath. And, you know, if our digestive system is struggling, if your gut biome is out of balance, if your vagus nerve is firing all day with stress, if you have a depleted digestive enzyme situation, all of these things that we can treat individually with nutrition and supplements, we can address the whole lot with the breath. Morning, Mags. So that's why I'm even more excited about this breathing, the more I've really been diving into James Nestor's works and Patrick McCowan, Boteco, which we used to teach in our gym like 15 years ago. But I'd never really got down into the depths of the importance of it and the understanding how it can transform. As you know, my passion is healing and helping people who have been diagnosed allegedly in terminal or incurable. We now understand that a lot of these diseases are not terminal or don't need to be, or and they're not incurable. But very rarely, it's very difficult for doctors now because their hands are tied. They don't have all these techniques, they're not trained in it, and they're not allowed to say certain things. And a lot of them I know are understanding that the cold water's huge, that breathing's huge, but that's really not the remit that you're going to get if you go there. So this is why Scotland's Wild Medicine is coming to you to help you to understand what I'm now understanding and get excited about the power of Scotland's wild medicine, because it is wild that we are not teaching this in schools, and we have to change that. And morning, Sharon. So the book, when it comes to you, I want you to share it with as many people as you can. We've got an ebook. Have the ebook on your phone, you know, because what has to happen is that the book will give you the knowledge, yeah, but you don't need any more knowledge, you know. But what you do need is practice. And this is why we need to come back to communities like this, where we can breathe together, support each other, help each other. You know, the fear comes in. What happens when I breathe too deeply? What happens when I hyperventilate? What happens if I pass out? It's fear, because we're so fear driven in our culture, and particularly now it drives me insane. I'm like, Nicola Sturgeon, get on TV and breathe with your population, with your people, get them out of stress, talk to us like we're intelligent beings, and we'll help you, rather than what happens to me is I get so triggered by this trying to terrify us to make us do what they want. Now, so it's not about breaking the rules, it's about understanding why you would behave in a certain way for the greater good of all, and not just people who've got COVID, people who've got cancer, people who are suicidal and anxious and depressed and broke and hungry. So there's a whole thing going on there. So what we can do as humans, we can tribe up with other like-minded people that believe in action and love for each other rather than sitting in the house in fear and snitching and phoning the police on each other. I mean, that's just never, ever going to work. Surely we all must know that by now. We have to reach out, we have to listen, and we have to understand why people are feeling the way that they are, because it's all emotion driven. And guess what breathing can do? It can change the way you feel. And don't take my word for it. Let's do a quick 4-7-8 before we go into today's exercises. Because today I'm going to talk to you specifically about healing dis-ease, chronic pain, anxiety, depression. It increases your bone density, calms the vagus nerve, and also feeds the brain more oxygen so that you can see through the fog of madness that is out there right now, so that you can clearly feel what is the right move for you. And it may be nothing. It may be simply just to really focus in on learning how to fly this spaceship that you are part of. Okay, so let's do the 4-7-8. Breathe in. Hold. And out. And in. Hold. And out. And in. Hold. And out. Last one. In. Hold. And out. Okay. And just some nice, easy breathing. Yes, Mary. Mary's just brought up a point that she's homeschooling. So I think that's what we'll look at next week. Let's do something for the mum, the homeschoolers, the kids. Something that we can all do to start really teaching our kids this powerful, powerful, supernatural, superhero power that we have. Okay. So I'm going over a lot of the stuff that I've talked about over the last 10 days, but I think it's critical to really let this information be embodied by your mind. And if you are not, if you do not believe you can heal yourself, drink gin. It's another solution, Emma, for sure. You know, one of the very first healings that I saw in front of my own eyes was a girl that had been diagnosed with MS. And I said to her, have you never Googled people who have healed MS? And she said, no. And I was like, wow. And that's, I would immediately, because I think part of being cynical is that when people tell you things, you just instantly check in and see, think, is that true? Particularly something as big as this is incurable. So I said, well, say I am healing. So she said, I am healing. I said, how does that feel? And she said, well, it doesn't feel true. So that's absolutely normal and common. If you've been told, you know, this is where you're at, it can't be changed, that you would feel, when I get you to say I am healing, that you would feel it's not true. So going from I am unable to heal myself to I am healing myself can be, feel like an enormous gulf, so huge that you might not even try, because you've taken on the narrative, I am powerless within this body. And so for me to say, well, you're not actually, you're powerful, just seems like bullshit, let's face it. So what we have to do is we have to say, would you like to believe that you can heal yourself? So I am open to the possibility of healing. Because if you can get sick, then you can get well. Surely that's kind of basic physics. If it can go that way, it can go that way. But you may not know how to do it, which is a completely different debate. But, and that's what's fantastic about the internet now. We're looking at people who have defied the odds. And Kelly Turner's book, Radical Remissions and Then Radical Hope, will categorically show you that people have been told it's all over and they've not chosen not to take that on. So read her books if you're in that position. And understand as well that we're all going to die. It's just this process that we currently use that terrifies people, that drives me insane. So when learning these techniques, preventing disease, and if you were ever unlucky enough to have a diagnosis or a prognosis in the future, which let's face it, at 60 is highly likely, that you have the techniques and the protocols. You know, one of my friends recently went through some breast cancer treatment and she said to me, thank God I've been listening to you for 20 years, because she took some of the treatments, but she also had a lot of her own protocols to put in place. And that really is the position you want to be in. You're just like, well, what can they do for me and what can I do for myself? So let me assure you, breathing is absolutely key. And if you can get on Neeraj's 7-day free course, you will get all the information you need about how this change in oxygen and carbon dioxide and holding the breath, how that impacts the system and why old injuries start to heal and why you start to feel more alert and alive. And I think, like I was saying yesterday, the power of holding your breath, I really had no idea about that, I have to be completely honest. I was doing it, but I didn't understand what was happening. And I think you become more conscious when you understand the science and the neuroscience behind it. And then it becomes more powerful, because now I'm actively going on to increase my breath holds, whereas I didn't really care about that before. All I cared was that I got the nice buzz, and that's okay too. But now I'm like, right, okay, I'm going to have to focus on this and get better at it, because I want to make sure that, again, it's not about not dying for me. If I take a heart attack today and dropped out of this planet, that would be fine. But what I don't want is to be living in a body that doesn't work, quite simply, if I can possibly help it. Well, who was the course? Could you say that again, please? Yes, it's Neeraj Soma Breath, and there's a 7-day free course. And it's already started, so I'm not sure if you'll be able to get into it now, but check it out and have a look. I'll put a link on afterwards. Okay, so when you come out of fight or flight and into rest, restore and repair, and when you're sleeping properly, can't emphasise breathing and sleeping. I mean, how crazy is that? Our two superpowers, so that you can actually, when you go into these deep states, the body just unplugs from the matrix, from the madness, and then it just does all the detoxing and repairing through the night at certain times, only if you're sleeping. Your healing hormones will flood in between 10 and 2 a.m. only if you're sleeping. So be mindful of working with the circadian rhythm if you're compromised. These are simple three things that you can do that you're not going to hear on the BBC. So you have to learn and understand yourself these powers, and do not ever think because it's free, it doesn't have a value. And I think that's a big problem in our consumer, material, mental world. It's like, well, people don't pay for it, they don't value it. I'm going to change that belief, let me assure you. It's all there for us. So, and I'm not saying you might not need a helping hand from the system, you might, but see, if you get into this stuff now, there's a very, very big chance that you won't. So the vagus nerve, which if you're not familiar with the vagus nerve, it runs from the base of the spine all the way up into the brain. And it's, vagus is the Latin name for wander. It wanders everywhere. Even they reckon it's that our facial expressions come from the stimulation or not of the vagus nerve. It wanders into all our internal organs. So when it's triggered, and that's when fear comes in, you'll feel it in your gut, in your belly, chest, because it's in everything. So it's a really interfering nerve, negatively and positively, depending on how we view it. So allow the vagus nerve, and you know, Sally Gray, another woman I highly recommend you follow, she's incredible. She's got an amazing group, mastery group. And she says it's not the big traumatic things that have happened in the past. For example, if you've had any sexual abuse or physical abuse, there's things that we can remember that were traumatic. But what happens, why we get worn down, is because we're triggering, triggering, triggering all day, every day without realising it. So we need to learn, you know, even washing your face with cold water calms the vagus nerve, and breathing calms the vagus nerve, and obviously getting fully into the water calms the vagus nerve. And there's lots of other ways to calm the vagus nerve. Just Google it and you'll see. keep yourself calm, back into the rest, restore and repair. And then the brain starts to light up in different ways. When you start to say, what would it take for me to be completely healed? Is that very intention, that question, the brain, the front part of the brain starts to light up to help you find the solutions. It's all there. If you don't believe me, try it. Don't be that person that in 10 years' time realises that the power was within and you just were too cynical to try it. So whatever it is that you want, like I was saying yesterday, really becoming really clear about what it is you want. And I think most of us never really thought, I want to be peaceful, I want to be calm, I want to be alert, compassionate, empathetic, but not stupid, right? Because this is what's happening right now, is a lot of us are trusting, and there's nothing wrong with trusting, but you also need to be aware that there's people we can't trust. So you need to just be like, okay, let me release, let me, any triggers that come in, let me just stay open and wide so that I can tap into my intuition, and you're not relying on me or anyone else to help you find your truth. And then when you start to do this, you can do this when you're healing, is that treatment necessary for me? And that you're so sure about your own inner intelligence that you never have to waver from it. There's no doubt. There's no doubt about the intelligence, because what happens now is we've got so many people giving us so many different points of view. We don't know what the hell we should do first. So this work will really help you tune in. When you ask the questions, guide me to the right tutorial videos, to the right information, to the right people to help me heal, to help me create a magnificent business, to help me change the world, to help me heal Scotland. When you start to really say, right, okay, I need to tribe up with others on that frequency, that's what happens. You know, ask and you will receive, seek and you will find. That's how it works, you know, but you have to be alert. And now, because we've got so much information coming at us, it can be very confusing and overwhelming, and we really don't know what to believe. There's so much stuff coming out. So anyway, back to healing. So when you can stay in that rest, restore and repair mode, your vagus nerve's like, yeah, I'm going to send nice information into their internal organs. I'm going to spread a smile over that face. It's all good in the hood. So you're then controlling that system, instead of being a victim of it, which most of us, and I include myself, have been. You're getting triggered, your subconscious mind is sending out negative information. It's like, there's a problem, there's a problem, there's a problem. And you don't understand that the body's talking to you. So therefore, you just, we work through our emotions and we say and do things that are not helpful, that have actually got nothing to do with this moment in time. It's to do with the past, or it's to do with fear of the future. So breathing, and today we're just going to do some breathing exercises. Breathing is the very, very first thing that you can do to control everything in that body. Everything. It's free. And it's a bit like eating. You can stop doing it, i.e. controlled pause, retention. You can do more of it. You can do less of it. You can play about with it. Learn how to fly your own body. This is what we're waking up to. You know, the waking up thing can be, we're using that like, oh, they're not awake yet. Well, they're really awake. You know, again, it's just all judgment and separation. We all have this power. Some people don't believe it. Some people have never used it. Some people are a bit, well, I would love to think it, but you know, they still have self-doubt. They don't understand. And we're going to change that with Scotland's Wild Medicine. So let's just start off, we'll do the alternate nostril breathing. So blow your nose, and we'll do some of that. And then we're going to do just some 2-4 with a retention. Now, what I would like you to do is get your phone or get some way to time your breath hold. Now, what Neeraj recommends is that you 3 times a day. So first thing in the morning, maybe lunchtime, and then at night, just do a breath hold without any conscious breathing. Just stop and out and then hold and see how long you can hold your breath for. Because that will give you a lot of indication as to what's going on in the body. Okay. And there's certain times of the day where you'll be able to hold your breath a lot longer. And I'm sure you're aware of that now. If you, some days you go for a run, if you go in the morning, you feel great. If you go at night, you feel like lead. We're all working. Some people are morning people like me. Some people are evening people. So work out when it's going to be the best time for you and really get to know that body. And as I was telling you the other day, my friend Alina has a watch that really warns her when she goes into stress state, and it buzzes. It's like, whoa, you're moving out of the chill state. You're going into fight or flight, and she can then just breathe her way back down into coherence, which I think is great. I'm actually thinking of getting one just out of curiosity. It's really helped her. And I think, and she's got three young children, and all boys, and obviously a husband, and homeschooling, and you know, if you can stay calm and amongst that, then it's pretty quite incredible. So these toys are there, you don't need them, but can they help? Absolutely they can help. We're all different, so you decide what you need to help you stay calm. Otherwise you can just go in your feelings, oh, stress is in, and then you just breathe it out. The 4-7-8, boom. You know you're going to change your state. Okay, so you're ready to do some alternate notes. So give your nose a good blow. And then we're going to do the alternate nose breathing. And what I want you to really focus on is close your eyes and pay attention to what's happening inside the body. How does it feel? Okay, because this is your superpower, remember. You are starting, even with this intention, to starting to take over from the past, from the programming that is the past. Old habits, etc., that are in there, all the old hurts and disappointments, etc. You're starting to pump up, put oxygen into the body. The cells, remember, start to expand and lighten. And then when we stop and we actually hold the breath, and it's two different hemispheres of the brain. And again, the body does this naturally. I think it's about 20 minutes on one side, 20 on the other. All that intelligence is going on without us even understanding. So we're going to do the alternate nose breathing, and then we're going to stop and we're just going to pay attention to what's inside the body, what's happening. So I want you to just mark yourself in terms of stress out of 10 right now. One being completely zen, 10 being completely stressed. And just see, measure the change that you are going to make when you do this. Okay, so you put your Peter pointer finger. Try to phone me there. They might well try again. So what we're going to do is breathe in. And then block that nostril off and breathe out through the other one. And breathe in. Block that one off. And breathe out. Now you can hear I'm much more congested, that sign. And breathe in. Walk that one off and out. Change. Just do it in your own time. Okay. Now just close your eyes and feel. Pay attention. There could be tingling, feeling a space, calm. Okay. So again, literally 2 minutes. Make it a practice. What I recommend is that you find a breathing technique that you like and do that for a week so that you get really competent at it. Really taking over the body, your back, you've got free will, you decide what's happening, not the body. You have that power with your intention and your breath and your commitment to the practice that you, I'm back, I'm taking over. Okay, so now we're going to do the 2-4. So if you can, have a something to time your breath hold. And remember, it doesn't matter what anybody else is doing. The world record's 24 minutes. So it's highly unlikely you'll be able to do that straight away. But this is a training. It's like you're training for a marathon. You're just training this body to be stronger and healthier and way, way, way more flexible and adaptable. And understanding that you can come in and take over with a simple, simple breathing exercise, alkalize your blood, any. Your gut biome will be balanced. Joe Dispenza's work again, people, food allergies disappear in that instant because the body resets itself. You tune into a different data stream of information. So you go in with what you want to heal, what you want to attract, what you want to be, whatever it is, you have that clear intention and then you breathe your way there. Or if there's something that you need to let go of, let it go. While you're doing this. Okay, so we're going to breathe in for 2 and out for 4, and I'm just going to do this. I'm going to do some of the breathing with you, but then I'll be talking you through what's actually happening. So we're going to breathe in for 2, out for 4. So we're going to do that for around 30, and then we're going to do a breathe in, and we're going to breathe out saying who, H-U, That's going to be the out breath, and then we're going to hold the breath, and you're going to time and see how long you can hold it for. Okay, it's just a game, there's no right or wrong, it's just about you expanding your lungs, expanding your cells, expanding your consciousness and awareness, and dropping all limiting beliefs that you are not powerful. Okay, did I forget anything there? So we're going to breathe in for 2, out for 4, we're going to breathe out on the who, and then we're going to hold the breath. And then after we do that, we're going to breathe in, and then we're going to use our pelvic floor muscles and our abdominal muscles to push that energy all the way into the brain. Remember, past the thalamic gate, ding, it comes up, hits the pineal gland, and gives us that beautiful chemistry. Okay, so I want you to obviously follow my guidance, but really stay in your own body and become aware as you expand and expand into the field of unlimited potential. Okay, so we're going to breathe in for 2 and out for 4. And then when I tell you, you're going to breathe in, out with who, and then you're going to hold. And then, when you need to breathe in, you're going to breathe in, use all your muscles, and push that beautiful energy up into the brain and become one with the field. Is that clear? Let's do it. Okay, so breathe in and out. If you can do in and out through your nose, then fantastic. But in through the nose and out through the mouth is good too. It doesn't really matter. You're just going to practice. Close your eyes and just become aware of how you're feeling. Make sure you're in a nice, safe position and really you're expanding the cells, filling the body with oxygen. and really go for it. If you've been doing this for 10 days now, you can really pump up this Lilo that is this body. And think of your affirmation, I am healing. I'm letting go of all limiting beliefs. I have the power. Feel yourself expanding. You're probably starting to get lightheaded. A lot of tingling going on. This is you taking over and really using your intention, your power to heal yourself. Okay, we're all the way in. And the who. Focus on your third eye. You might want to take another breath in. All the way out. And hold it into your first controlled pause. And time it now if you can. Again, have your eyes closed and really dissolve into this energy. Feel that you are boundaryless, at one with the potential field, the field of unlimited possibilities that you are part of when you let go all the claptrap you've gathered throughout your life. Feel the cells expand. If you need to breathe, breathe in and out and hold again. And just keep doing that until we're ready. Allow yourself to dissolve. Become the waves. Dissolve from being the particles into the waves. Blend into the universal field of potential. Okay, and when you get that big urge to breathe, we're going to breathe all the way in and use all the muscles to push the energy up. So breathe in, tighten the pelvic floor, the abdominal, push through the chest, the heart center, into the brain. Squeeze, 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 push the energy through the brain to the pineal glands. Feel that energy. You are the creator. It's up to you. You have the power. Feel the cells expand. 3, 2, 1, and just let it all go. Let it go. And keep your eyes closed. And just feel the tingling. Feel the intelligence that is you. Allow it. Bask in the afterglow. Set yourselves free. Let go. Let go. Let go a little bit more. And a little bit more. Okay. So you're probably feeling some energy there, some tingling, maybe a bit lightheaded. That's what you want to be feeling. Now that you're out the way, you've pumped up the cells, the light, the information, it's all just rearranging itself with the intelligence without your help. The body doesn't need your help. And just allow it. Something to drink. So, we're going to do one more. If you've had enough, that's fine. Just rest, restore and repair. tap in to that intelligence. You might find memories come up, you might get insights. There's no right or wrong here. I've been doing this work for a long time. It can be different every time. Some days it's amazing, some days it's more like hard work. It's all okay. But just know that you're back and you're in this intelligent field and you're now understanding, wow, I'm actually the one that is doing everything in here. I'm believing, I'm perceiving, I'm projecting, I'm thinking, I'm feeling, I'm doing all of these things. And now I can breathe differently to really power up my practice for the law of attraction, if you want to look at it from that perspective. Okay, so again, really being clear about what it is you want or what it is you don't want. You can use this to let go of something. And what we're going to do is just a simple 2-2 this time. And this is the last one we're going to do. Okay, and again, in the body, take your attention in the body. And it's really helpful to close your eyes because then you're not wondering what's going on there, what's happening there. You want to come out the mind and into the body. Your body is your subconscious mind. All your secrets are held there. All the problems and all the resistance is in there. And now we are really going in there to let go of the past so that you can create whatever it is your heart desires. Okay, so we're going to, after this, we're just going to do the same thing again, except it's going to be 2-2. We'll do the retention, and then we'll pull all the way in. And you become aware of how long you can hold your breath, so that you can start to stretch it. So you've got a starting point. You're like, right, okay, and I can maybe do a second more and a second more. Okay? And then I'm going to just take you in after that to a very short, gentle meditation. So let's do it. Okay, so get clear. What is the thing that would make you so much happier today? Is there something you need to let go of? Is there something you need to attract? You're going to attract. You decide. Maybe it's just optimum health and clarity and vitality. Okay, so breathing in. Now it's up to you with the kind of energy you put into this. You maybe just want to do it nice and gently. You maybe want to really start pumping it up. Two more, one more, and all the way in, and and then into your second controlled pause, and just hold the breath for as long as you can. And if you can measure it, great. If not, don't worry, just enjoy the buzz. Close your eyes and let go. Dissolve into this field, the soup, quantum soup of potential, of possibilities. Focus in your heart center and allow it to open and release anything that no longer serves you. Dissolve, let go, become one with the field. Release all boundaries. Be aware of your skin and all the way beyond the skin. And then when you're ready, take a nice deep breath in. Your pelvic floor muscles, your abdominal muscles, and squeeze that energy up through the thalamic gate into the pineal gland and feel the cells expand. Push, push, push. As the pineal gland releases the chemistry, keep your focus on your third eye, and then just let go. And keep the eyes closed and keep your attention in the forehead. What can you see? What can you feel? Allow the energy to move. Let go. Let go and let the divine intelligence flow without your restrictions or resistance. Let go. And if you feel any resistance coming in or any energy moving, just allow it. Welcome it, embrace it, and let it go. Feel the cells expand as you raise your vibration. Allow your vibration to rise. Allow the light to flow through your meridian system, through the heart. Let the heart expand in unconditional love. And share that love with every cell in the body and every human on the planet. Let go and allow yourself to rise in the powerful energy of the field. And allow anything that no longer serves you to dissolve as you become lighter and lighter. The frequencies gently lift you up. The cells expand and you go into tune and into harmony with the Schumann resonance, and healing happens. Allow it. Allow all past hurts, blocks, subconscious traumas, memories. Allow it all to dissolve now. Allow yourself to rise, to waken up to this phenomenal power, the reconnection. Let go. Trust and surrender to the process. Open your heart. Let the love flow. Uninhibited, effortlessly, easily. Feel the cells expand in joy, sunbathing in this diamond light that has the blueprint for health. You can connect and tune into any time you desire. Allow the cells to gently increase in frequency, dissolving the past, dissolving anything that no longer serves you, allowing you to expand and awaken to the magnificence of who you truly are. Feel it in your heart. Remember why you're here. Feel the joy and the connection with everyone on this live right now. feel gratitude, appreciation. Take your attention outside the body, outside your house, as we rise above the planet and we look down on the planet, our home, the home we've not looked after with unconditional love and compassion. And let's just beam down these healing frequencies to every human on this planet. Feel that unconditional love for this magnificence of our Mother Earth. Feel the energy around everyone in this call as we give thanks to each and every one of you. And take your attention gently back into your heart center, in the middle of your chest. And in your own time, just open your eyes. And just keep that lovely feeling with you for the rest of the day. The week, the weekend, and your life. Okay. Well, thank you again for joining. Your enthusiasm has been amazing, and I really appreciate it. Please send me a message if you have any experiences, if you feel that your confidence in your body and that you're changing the way you're seeing the body, because you know, so many of us are in a very, thanks Meg, so many of us are in a very negative relationship with the cells that we are. Thanks Anne. More. Yeah, you're right. We need to do this, don't we? Thank you Emma and Karen. So when we can really go into these expanded states, you know, this, I believe, really is the way for us to get through whatever it is we're going to have to get through over the next few months and years perhaps, because whatever, I don't know if anybody really genuinely knows, thank you Holly and Diane, so we need to tribe up, we cannot allow ourselves to be divided. And I know, thanks Deirdre, lovely to see you, and Janice, yeah. We need to look after each other and we need to stay in these higher states. And it's challenging, let's face it, because, and very often you have in your own household differing beliefs. So, but that can be your, when you're being triggered like that. Oh, I'm sure we will, Patricia, as soon as all these restrictions go, we'll all get together and we'll do this together and then we'll jump in the sea. So we need to make sure that we don't allow the divide and conquer strategy to work, to win. Thanks Joan. Great Jean, that's lovely. Yeah, this is really healing, you know, and this is, I believe, so exciting for all of us to have this power within and to be able to help each other and tribe up. And I'll message you afterwards. You know, when we open up to this work, there has to be an element of trust. And very often energy moves and energy can get stuck and sometimes it can feel uncomfortable. Pat, definitely tribes in the area for sure. So if you have discomfort in doing this work, just gently breathe your way through it. You know, when we detox, it can happen. You know, you can feel sick, you can have headaches, you can stop sleeping properly, you can be hot and cold, your mind can go crazy. And at that stage, that's when people stop and say, oh, I felt worse, much worse before. But you're, if you can just allow yourself to breathe through that and just understand, if you see the body is holding a lot of outdated information, like the hard drive in your computer, and what you're doing is you're giving permission for the body to release that outdated information, and it can be uncomfortable. But as soon as you, as long as you know that you have the power, that just breathe through it and intend, I'm letting this go, I'm welcoming it, I'm letting it go. Use the techniques, the tapping. It's all, go to my YouTube channel. There's lots of stuff there, not just my channel. There's amazing stuff there for free that can help you. If you're stuck, ping me a message. The thing is not to judge what's happening, because judgment is contraction. And when what contraction means is I'm going to catch that thing and I'm going to hold on to it. So, for example, a story comes in. Oh, I am a really poor sleeper. I am a worrier. The most powerful affirmation starts with I am. And if you don't want it, do not say it. So you reset that. What would it take for me to stop worrying? What would it take for me to sleep like the, the most powerful restorative sleep? So you start to ask the questions, you turn it round from I am, this is crap, this is shit. What would it take for me to feel differently? What would it take? How does it get better than this? So all of these techniques, they help to change the narrative, to change the sails. Remember, we're the pilot of this thing. Where are we going? We like when we're in problem mode, we're in a contracted negative state. Breathe your way out of it and then see the solutions appear. That's how it works. Anyway, I'm going to go now. Tomorrow, what we're going to do is we're going to lie down and breathe. So I'm going to take my little tripod to beside the bed so that I know that you're all going to be safe, and we're going to go for it. Because I won't be doing a live on Saturday because I'm doing something very, very exciting, which I'll tell you about another time. And then on Sunday, I will do a live for the last day. Tomorrow, make sure you can lie on the floor or lie on your bed, whatever. It'll be 9 o'clock again. I will see you all then. Huge love and gratitude. Thank you. Ciao, ciao.